Morning, guys. Today we're going to discuss a very important topic: how to design a CPU. CPU, Central Processing Unit, which consists of ALU and CU. CU stands for Control Unit and ALU, Arithmetic and Logical Unit. For designing of CPU, we must have some registers, some general purpose register and some special purpose registers. Let us draw the ALU first. This is the ALU. Here we do have a special purpose register accumulator, and here a temporary register, data register or DR. Both of them are connected with the ALU. Here we are having some general purpose register. Let us make it R1 and R2. We are having one internal data path. ALU will give the feedback here. Accumulator is also connected with it, as well as the data register and the general purpose registers also. Here we will be having one particular register, name is MAR, or memory address register. Here we will be having one special purpose register, name is instruction register, which will hold the instruction for the very first time when it will be fetched from the memory. Then it will fade to the decoder. As you know, in high level languages, the language is not understandable by the computer. That is why we do need the decoder to decode it to the machine level language, which the machine can understand. After decoding, it is fed to the timing and control unit, which will generate the control signal, which I mentioned earlier also as CU. So these two are the most essential part of the CPU, that is ALU and CU. Now timing and control unit will give the control signals to almost all the devices of the CPU. Here we will be having one special purpose register, that is program counter or PC. The job of PC is to hold the address of the next instruction. Now, before designing of any kind of CPU, first we must know what is the instruction set, because before designing the computer architecture, we must know the instruction set architecture. Why? Sometimes you know that some softwares don't run on your PC. It is said that it is not compatible or incompatible. Now, what is a software? A software is nothing but a collection of programs. And what is a program? A program is nothing but a collection of instructions. Now, what is the instruction? Instruction is nothing but collection of some micro operations. Now, if we have the arrangement of hardware which can execute all the micro operations, then those particular instructions can be executed. If all the instructions can be executed, then all the programs which are written using those instructions, those can be executed. If all the programs written using those instructions can be executed, then all the softwares can run in your particular PC. So the most essential part is instruction set architecture, or ISA. What is instruction set architecture? Instruction set architecture is the collection or the set of all the instructions which your machine is going to execute. That is, we will design our machine accordingly depending upon the ISA, so that our machine can execute all the instructions individually. Now, you can understand in our daily life how many types of program we used to write, how many types of software we used to write. For example, we use VLC Media Player, we use Photoshop, we use some text editor like VI Editor. But the basic programs, the variety, the dimension of the program is so vast that we must have a large number of large set of instructions. But here today we are going to discuss the very primitive, the very basic type of CPU. So better let us make it an optimum one. Fine. So our main motive is to design a very primitive CPU which can execute all the logical and arithmetic operations. You know that arithmetic operations basically of four types: plus, minus, multiplication and division. And logical operations, you know that equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, etc. So here for addition we must have one adder. Adder means it will execute the add operation. Like for example, let us make it add R1. For minus, do we need subtractor for doing the subtraction, or we can do it without having a subtractor? Now let us discuss it. If I write 15 minus 9, answer is very simple, it is 6. Here we are using a subtractor, but if I write 15 minus plus 9, 15 plus minus 9, the result is again 6. Here we don't need the subtractor, rather we need here adder. What we did, the trick is very simple. We just converted 9 to minus 9, for which a particular NOT gate is good enough to do this. So we don't need subtractor. We can do subtraction by use of addition and one particular complement operation. Let us call it CMP R1. Now here R1 I am writing just to make it generalized. You can write R1, R2, whatever you need. Now if we have adder, then it is very easy to understand that what is multiplication. Multiplication is nothing but repetitive addition. If I write 4 to the 8, that means we are adding 4 two times. So we need adder. So here we have adder. By using the adder multiple number of times, we can implement the multiplication. And here we are having division. You know that for division, we need multiple time of subtraction. And here using the adder and the complement, we can use two's complement method to implement the subtraction. So by using multiple number of subtraction, we can define the division also. Now, here we have complement, here we have add operation. Using these two, we can cover all the arithmetic operations. Now for logical operation, what will happen? I hope you know that NAND gate and NOR gate, these two particular NAND gate and NOR gate are known as the universal gate, using which we can design any circuit. Here we have complement, that is the NOT gate. If we can have one particular AND operation and over which we can have the complement, then we can basically have the NAND gate. And you know that NAND gate is the universal gate using which we can implement any kind of logical operations. So we don't need anything else, but we just need one AND operation along with these two. These three operations are good enough to cover all types of arithmetic and logical operations. This is the most optimum way to implement the arithmetic and logical operations. Now, to complete the instructions and architecture, we do need some other types of operation also. That is known as the move operation. Now, move operation. We can have accumulator here. We are having R1 here. We are having R2 here. Now, different types of move operation are needed. For example, move accumulator, comma R1. Move accumulator, comma R2. Move R1, comma accumulator. Move R2, comma accumulator. Move R1, comma R2. And move R2, comma R1. That is nothing but the all types of permutations of R1, R2 and accumulator. So using these 9 operations, we can perform almost all the arithmetic and logical operations which we need to perform in any CPU, and this is the most primitive type of CPU here in front of you. One more operation we need. Normally in high level language, you know very well, we use some go-to statement or some kind of statement. We must implement that jump here also. So here, let us have one jump. So here we have jump. And if we look into the basic organization of computer, here input device, here output device, here is a CPU. Here always we used to have the memory. And memory, you can see that these arrows are bidirectional. That is, we do need read and write operation. So here another operation is needed, that is move accumulator comma memory, and 12 move memory comma accumulator. Here accumulator comma memory is nothing but memory write operation, and move memory comma accumulator is nothing but it is memory read operation. So here in front of you, I discussed the basic components of a very basic CPU, which can perform most of the logical and arithmetic operations by using the instruction set architecture. And here for you, I have shown you the very basic optimized instruction sets, which consist of add, complement, so subtraction also, add, so multiplication, add and complement, subtraction, so division, and, and not, NAND, so all the logical operations, and different types of move statement, which consist of register reference instructions and some memory reference instructions, and along with that jump. In the next class, what we will do? In the next class, we will try to design the instructions and architecture properly along with the proper binary encoding of all the instructions which till date probably we are not aware of. We write high level language programs in C, C++, Java, but how the machine works, we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.